Hey guys, what's going on? Daryl again here from the Neon Tourist YouTube channel. As you can see behind me, I'm at the world famous Treasure Island on the Las Vegas Strip. So the other day, my video of walking from the airport to the Las Vegas Strip was posted on Reddit, and in the comment section, somebody asked for a video showing how to get from the Strip to a major dispensary. So since I'm here at Treasure Island, and Planet 13 is the closest, I'm going to show you how to get there now. Alright guys, so unlike the airport walk, this is going to be a lot more fun, and there's a lot more to see along the way. So this shouldn't be too long of a video, but we'll see how long it takes us to get there. Now the last time I did one of these videos, I had my stopwatch going on my wrist, but I figured since I'm not cutting anything the entire time I'm on the way there, we can just see how long it takes based off the time on the video. Plus, I'm sure if you saw that last video, you saw that my watch was being a little finicky about when it wanted to turn on, because it kept trying to go into power saver mode and it was just a whole mess. So now we're just gonna base it off of the timer on the video, and we'll see how long it takes us that way. Now while I'm walking over to Planet 13, Bree and Jules are already there, so I will have their footage added onto this one, as well as show you what they captured while I was on the way there.
So here we are at Planet 13 while Daryl is walking from the Treasure Island to the Planet 13. I'm not allowed to video in the actual dispensary, but they do have all of these amazing stores and eateries outside of the dispensary that I can video. Looks like they have a new one coming in called Perk. Looks like it's a coffee and tea place.
If you saw from our other video that we posted on the channel, we went out to the downtown Summerlin Farmers Market this morning, and just as we were leaving, the wind started picking up. Apparently there's a wind advisory for this afternoon. So hopefully you'll be able to hear me the whole way. Now the convenient thing about this is rather than needing to run across the busy Spring Mountain Road right here at Las Vegas Boulevard, there's a pedestrian bridge, so we can just cut across right over the traffic.
Yeah.
We might be able to get a decent shot of the sphere when we get down here. It's actually just on the other side of the palazzo here. Not quite. But it is right down that street there. The sphere is on Sands Avenue. And if you remember in my previous video where I mentioned that the east-west streets were named after the hotels that sat there previously, the Venetian Palazzo Resort right here is sitting where the original Sands was sitting, hence this being Sands Avenue.
Okay.
So now, I have to go the other way. Excuse me. Now, the Fashion Show Mall is another video entirely. I'm sure you can see from the approaching Neiman Marcus sign that this mall is a very high-end mall. There's lots of designer department stores in here. It's also one of the busiest malls because it's on the Las Vegas Strip and the pricing is not the best. So if you do feel the need to go to a mall rather than just one of the local malls or use Amazon, just be prepared to pay when you come here. Now, technically the fastest way for me to get to Planet 13 from where I'm at would be to cut through the mall. But I have a sneaking suspicion that most people attempting this walk are going to be doing it at night. And unlike a lot of other things on the Strip, this mall does close. I'll put their hours up on the screen here, but off the top of my head, I think they close at 9 o'clock. Nine or 10, not sure. And there you can see Trump Tower there in the background. Trump Tower does not actually sit on the Strip, it sits back from the Strip. But its placement was definitely thought out by not having it directly on the boulevard. Because when you're coming down Las Vegas Boulevard and you're looking south to north, because the boulevard curves, you end up having a situation where the Trump Tower ends up looking like it's sitting square in the middle of Las Vegas Boulevard. Also, when you come down here at night, since the mall will most likely be closed, you won't have this much traffic to deal with cutting through here.
So this place has all the merchandise. Some cool looking coffee cups for perk when they open. Planet 13 coffee cups. Because you always need your coffee. Cute Planet 13 shirts in different colors. Ooh, they even have tie-dye shirts. Loving that. Super cute.
Yes.
Very cute. Yeah. 13 jerseys. Some snacks. Looks like they have a clearance rack. Some stuff in here. Looks like they're out with the cold weather.
Now, today is only supposed to be a high of 79, so it actually feels really nice out right now. But this isn't something I'd recommend you do in the dead of summer here. Our summer temperatures regularly get above 110 degrees. So walking anywhere in Vegas in the summer is a bad idea just because of how oppressively hot it gets. But if you want a challenge and you're not afraid to pass out due to heat stroke, then be my guest and try it. Now, oh, here we go. Something else to consider is that regularly get above 110 temperature. Sure, that's during the day, but at night, it's still 103 at midnight. So, whereas you don't have the actual sun beating down on you, it doesn't cool off in any sense of the term. Because honestly, the difference between 103 and 110 isn't really noticeable when you're already having to set the AC in your car to max winter. There you go, one of the few remaining Dillard's locations. Interestingly enough, when we were having discussions about starting this channel, we were having talks with my mom, and she was telling us that, you know, when I was younger and when she'd book our family vacation, she would do it exclusively through Dillard's Travel. And she wanted to start a travel agency. But we had the discussion furthermore that why did she stop using Dillard's Travel? She's like, well, because they went out of business. I'm like, right. I said, and for like your last 10 vacations, how did you book them? She's like, I went directly through Royal Caribbean, or I went directly through the airline. I'm like, exactly. Or Booking or Expedia or any of those other websites. It's easier now and more cost effective to book your own vacations through the existing websites than it is to go through a travel agency. Now, you do have the benefit of relieving some headache if you use a travel agent, if you just don't want to be bothered with anything yourself. But if you don't have that luxury, there's no problem with booking it yourself. Here I go again, bushwhacking it through a planner. But as you see here, very interesting sidewalk decision. You put the ramp down for the crosswalk, and then it's basically another round of real life Frogger. Be going as soon as these cars move here. Hopefully it should be slow enough. All right. That line was never ending. Still pulling in behind me. Now, would you believe we're already better than halfway there? We're heading that way. So, over here you have the VSSR rentals. So if you want to get a Corvette or a Slingshot to drive around the strip, it's a fun option. Haven't done that yet, but it is something I'm considering doing one day. Just because I like the look of those Slingshot cars and I've never driven one, so I want to see how it handles and if it's even comfortable for me to sit in. And, you know, who knows? I might decide I actually want to get one at some point. Especially if it uses less gas. Okay, should have missed up there. Sidewalk was uneven. All right, we go over here and hit this button to cross the street.
Wait.
Oh, there we go. Love it when that happens. You're gonna actually already see Planet 13 right there. There we go. Walk sign is on. So, this is the Deja Vu Love Blue. Oh my God, Love Boutique. If I could speak today, this is the Deja Vu Love Boutique and Erotic Heritage Museum. And I'm sure those of you that can read the signs about the show that's playing, they're not kidding. From what I understand, it's a couple gentlemen that basically use it to make balloon animals or something like that. I don't know, you let your imagination figure that one out. there's an adult store there too, if you guys decide you need to get any other practical supplies for your Vegas trip. And the area that we're walking over to now, this is actually where a lot of the gentlemen's clubs are here, so. Oh, here you go, train tracks. Okay, and we're not like down in there yet, but I mean, 20 minutes, not bad. Now, if you're going to try to come here, keep in mind that unlike a bar where they just card you sometimes, you cannot walk inside this facility if you do not have a valid ID that says you're over 21. Don't even try it. If you've got your ID in your room, go back and get it. They will not let you in without it. You're hearing that whining sound. It's this lovely construction down here. Oh, look, more state flowers. Remember those from the airport video? I said they pop up everywhere. Also, keep in mind, this construction crew's out here. This is a Saturday afternoon. Alright, and here we are at Planet 13. Okay, I know this is a security checkpoint I'm going through, so I'm going to have to turn off the video to go through here, but we've made it, so let's go inside and see if we can find Bree and Jules.
Okay, so I am checked in with the dispensary. It's pretty easy. You just put in your first name and your last initial of your, the first initial of your last name, and then your phone number, opt into texting, and it'll send you a welcome text saying you're in line. Once your time comes up, your person line comes up, they'll send you another text, and you just go up to the door that, or the stand with your number on it. That's it. Pretty easy.
Okay, that was pretty nice. You just check your ID when you come in. This is pretty awesome. A sign that says, do not jump or stomp on the interactive floor, but that's pretty cool. Well, that looks like I found Bree already. Hey, Brie. Oh, you found me a ghost. Awesome. Thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah. You guys haven't seen these, and that's what this video is about, but these ghost energies are awesome. And let me get the autofocus to work on this here. But basically, here you go. This only has 10 calories, no sugar, and this is our VGK or Golden Knight style can that they carry at T-Mobile Arena for the Knights games. So, having fun?
Yeah, I'm signed in waiting to go in. So.
Okay.
But I've done a walk-up area and done my commentary on it, so I don't know if you want to do your commentary on it or not.
Okay. We got a call from Mom that Jules forgot her ID at home.
Yep.
And?
So Jules is in the car.
Yeah. This is exactly what I said when I walked in here. If you do not have your ID, they will not let you in. So apparently Jules forgot her ID at home. So she's sitting in the car waiting for us. Yeah, that's kind of cool. The breakfast junkies. That's kind of cool.
We humans are seldom just a walking flesh in our pocket.
This is kind of cool.
Hello there. Welcome to Planet 13, the world's largest cruise experience and complex.
Now, periodically, these things will actually pick up those lightsabers and fight. It's pretty awesome. So that was the lightsaber fight. It's pretty cool they do that. I have the Coolsville tattoo. This is the hit or miss grab bag tattoo where you either get a pretty cool cheap little tattoo or you get something way worse. The hot box fan. So what are the lockers for?
People have cannabis when they're trying to go into the lounge. You have to check the cannabis you have because you can't bring anything in there.
Understood. Awesome. Okay, thank you. So I don't know if you've heard that, but apparently they have a consumption lounge here, and anything that you've purchased out here, you can't take into the lounge. Anything that you purchased in the lounge, you can't bring out here. So if you purchase anything before going to the consumption lounge, you have to put your stuff in a locker. See if we can go down here and find Brie. This is cool. Stitched and stuff. That's awesome. Very portable store. Here's Bree. And I just have to wait to go in. So these aren't on a track. These are actually drones. All right, guys, well, that's going to do it for our walk to Planet 13 today. I hope you saw that it was a pretty quick little trip to get over here. And if you like this video and you want to see more, please leave a comment below and let me know what you'd like to see us film next. Also, please remember to like this video, subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell so you can be notified of any of our upcoming videos. Until next time, this has been Daryl with Neon Tourist. Safe travels.